Good evening. My name is Horn. I'm an actor. And I am an idiot. At least that's what I've been told. So it must be true. I came to the theater a long time ago. I don't remember why. I suppose I loved it even back then. It's hard to imagine now. So many years have passed, so many performances, so many curtain calls, and so many forgettable reviews. Life stands still in the theater, or at least it's so with me. I sit here, or I stand here, I make my exits and entrances. You come and see me. Whatever play I happen to be playing in at that particular time, and whatever role, you see me, but you don't know me. No, you see me as a collection of roles, good men, bad men, complicated men, men up to their ears in trouble, dramatic conflict. I played tragedy and played comedy. I've often played the buffoon, the butt of all the jokes. Well, that's the theater for you. A range of different parts and different characters. But who am I, really? Well, I'm an idiot who struts and frets upon the stage for his hour and then is seen no more. Yes, indeed, I am an idiot. I suppose you think I leave here when I'm done with a particular role or a particular show, but no, I never leave here. Oh, you leave here, yes. You go home to your comfortable homes and your comfortable lives, and what do I do? Well, I stay here, right here, and I wait for another role, another show, another audience, because without you, I'm nothing. I have no purpose, no existence. I must be seen, I must be heard. So to exist, I must be witnessed. Yes, it's sort of like the old dilemma of the tree falling in the forest. If it falls and there's no one there to hear it, does it make a sound? Well, I know the answer. It doesn't. It just falls. Like a tree falling in a silent movie. Like that. And I'm like that. If I perform on this stage and you're not here to see me, well, nothing really happens. I might as well not be here. So why did I come to the theater in the first place, That's a very good question, one I don't have a very good answer for, unfortunately. It was something to do, and I got sufficient praise for the work I did, and it inspired me to come back and try it again. Be in another show, and then another, and before I knew it, it had become my life. The only really reason to be alive, to be up here, and hot white lights, and my greasy face, and in that moment of pure hell, pure fear, pure electricity as I step out on the stage. And so, after all these years, I've become a prisoner of this stage. Now I haunt it like a ghost. I cannot leave. I do not want to leave because I don't know what it feels like to want anymore. Incredible, isn't it, not to know what wanting feels like? But no, that's true. I mean, that's all I feel is just this inexpressible aching feeling to be alive, to know that extraordinary doctor knows so well. I suppose you think it's easy to be up here talking to you like this, huh? Like it's just another day at work, and punching the clock, doing what comes naturally. It's work. It's hard work, learning lines and slaving away at things like character, motivation, diction, articulation, movement, blocking. Oh, and always know what do I do with my hand. It's always the same old problem, same old dilemma. And you never get used to it, no, because every night is different. Every play is different. Every theater is different. And you, every audience is different too. I'm always the same, but you're always different. And because you are, well, I must be different too. That's a odd paradox, eh? I'm not sure I really understand it even now. But then again, I don't understand much of anything anymore. Age has withered me, huh? And custom has staled my infinite variety, and I'm not fresh anymore. Not new. But still, I do it, though. Or I try to do it. Why? Well, because I'm an idiot.
Mr. Horn, your dinner.
Ah, my helpers, my keepers. Oh, good day to you.
Good evening.
Good evening, Mr. Horn. I trust we are well tonight.
Oh, well, well, well.
Would you like your food and here by your chair?
Oh, that would be very nice. That's very convenient.
There. Is there anything else you'd like?
No, you may go.
Very well, Mr. Horn. We'll come back for the dishes when you're done.
Very well. Ta-ta for now. let's see here. Some potatoes. Oh, that's good. A little veal, perhaps? I can't tell for sure. Oh, and some peas. Oh, I can't stand peas. Oh, but they're good for me. And it's always nice to have your meals provided for you. Yes. Let's see. Where was I now? I get sidetracked. Yeah. Acting, the theater. I could go on and on about that. It's my favorite subject. Well, my only subject, really. This darkened cabin here. You know, I haven't seen the light of day for years now. For all I know, it's always dark out there. The sun never shines. Perhaps the world has been relieved of all its beauty by now. There are no trees anymore, no flowers. Just a vast, purplish gray wasteland out there. But what does that matter to me? I'm an actor. It's always like it here, or it always could be. We can have a set to depict any kind of a scene we want, a seashore, a garden, a library, a city street, an office. It's all the same to me, and one step is just as real as another, yeah? You see? I live in an illusion. An illusion that's real. Well, I suppose you're wondering what I'm doing sitting out here eating my supper. I suppose it is rather odd, isn't it? But you know, I've been here so long that I've forgotten what looks odd and what looks normal. It all looks normal to me right now. But anyway, I'm sitting here eating like this because it says so right in the script. Yeah, I'm merely doing what's written in the script. Here. I'll show you, huh? It's right in here. I don't know where it is. What was that page in there? I think it was maybe page 5 or so, huh? Yeah. Oh, yes, right here. Yeah, you have page 5. He sits and eats his supper. That's me. That he is me. I'm supposed to eat my supper, and so I am. Yeah, and a very good supper it is, too. Oh yum, yum. I wish you could all eat it with me. I wish I could have my 2 young friends back there make meals for all of you. Oh, wouldn't that be fun? Yeah. We could all have our dinner together. Well, but we can't. You know, first of all, there are far too many of you out there. I don't think they have enough food to go around. The other reason is they don't think you exist. No, they don't see you like I see you. No, they think I'm crazy. And I am, in their eyes. Well, who knows? Maybe in everybody's eyes, huh? Maybe you think I'm crazy too, huh? Well, maybe I am crazy, huh? Maybe I am an idiot, huh? So what's wrong with that, huh? What's wrong with a little idiocy, eh? You know, a world without idiocy is a world without sanity, too, yeah? Well, just stop and think about it. I mean, if we were all sane, we wouldn't know what idiocy was, no. We wouldn't, huh? Because we're all sane. So, I'm an idiot. I'm proud of it. Hurrah! What are they putting in that, huh? That's not water. That's horse pit. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, let's see. Where was I now? Yes, the theater. The theater, yes, acting. I love the theater. Oh, yes, you know, the costumes, the bright lights, hush on opening night. Oh, what a thrill. What a sensation, yes. Yeah. I remember a long time ago, I was in a play with a young woman. Yes, oh, a beautiful young actress. She looked radiant in her costume and her makeup. Oh, we had a scene together, yes. We made love in the dark. To her darting eyes, and you could both feel it. Oh, something indescribable going on between man and woman, between actor and actress. the light's fault. They play tricks with your imagination. There are two kinds of actors, you know. Those who try it out and get a little taste of what it's like to be up on stage, being part of a company. And then there are others who become mesmerized by it, who become a part of it, part of the theater, part of the structure. I suppose you can guess which one I am. I can't let it go, even if I wanted to, which I don't. Why? Well, that's a question that I'm not sure that I want an answer for, so I don't ask. I never have. Ah, what's that? Oh, music. Ah, sweet music. Ah, I love sweet music. No, that's my other love, theater and music. But they often go together, don't they? Yes. Musical theater, opera, operetta, musicals. Or I sit here and listen. Listen to the nothingness and dream.
Mr. Horn, are you finished?
Clean up
now, if it's all right.
What? Well, yes, of course. Let's go right ahead.
some tea or coffee with your pill?
Yes, all right. So,
which is it, tea or coffee?
Tea, please.
Very well.
I've forgotten. I don't remember. Something about voices and music. Yes, I hear them. Yes, voices. And music, late at night when I'm lying in bed and trying to sleep. I mean, they just seem to come out of nowhere. They seem to appear out of the darkness and follow me. Now, of course, that's ridiculous, but I can swear at the time that it was real. It's like a voice of someone that I knew long ago, or a snatch of some song of Gilbert and Sullivan or something. I don't know. Has that ever happened to you? Am I mad? And then I just can't seem to get it out of my head. It's like I get stuck in there or something. And then there's another voice, and more voices, and more music, other music, other tunes, and none of it makes any sense really. But it's just real enough that it could make sense if it was just a little closer or a little bit clearer. Sometimes it's just too far away. It's all jumbled and too many voices all at once . And the music is it's recognizable, but not really. I mean, it's like maybe something that I made up or something that I heard somewhere. Oh well, what's the use? It's gone now.
Here's your tea. With cream and sugar.
No, I don't take sugar.
One lump or two.
I don't take sugar.
And cream?
No, I don't want any
I'll
cream.
I'll just pour you a little tiny bit.
No, I don't want any.
Here you are. Now you drink that right up and then it will be bedtime, all right? Forget your pill.
What's the use? What's the blinking use? I mean, you can't always get what you want. Isn't that what they say? But still, is it asking too much? I mean, you're dealt a hand and you must play it. But not to be too picky or too greedy. Sure.
Is everything all right, Mr. Ward? I thought I heard a noise. Are you all right? You're not drinking your tea. Is it not to your liking?
I asked for no sugar, and I was given two lumps.
Well, there. Now, I'm sure that's not your fault.
And I specifically asked for no cream, and I was given some.
Well, maybe you're right. Now, it is time for bed.
All I want is a... What's the use?
What's the matter? Does he want to go to bed?
I think so.
All right, then. It's getting a bit late now. I think we can have our tea another time, all right? Whew. A bit drafty in here, isn't it? Well, we'll get you under the nice warm covers, and then you'll be just fine, won't you? Don't you worry. We'll take good care of you.
I'm not crazy, am I? You're really out there, aren't you? You are, aren't you? Aren't you? I can't always tell for sure. Audiences all look alike. I mean, no offense. I mean, it's just the way it is. It always has been. Well, I mean, you sound different. You laugh at different things. Huh? You react differently, but you pretty much look the same. Yeah? Same heads and same bodies and same programs being consulted in dim light and crossed legs, same as his, huh? Oh, you know, I'm not supposed to smoke in here. It's against fire regulations, but it's in the script. Really, I think it's what the hell, page, must have been page 10 or page 11, yeah. Oh, yes, right here, page 11. He smokes a cigarette. Yeah. Well, if it's in the script, you have to do it, don't you? I mean, it would be disrespectful of the script not to. Huh? Yeah, it would feel disingenuous, huh? You know, I used to think that I could manipulate an audience into doing anything that I wanted. Huh? Well, if I wanted them to laugh, well, they would laugh. Huh? If I wanted them to suck in their breasts in horror, well, I could make them do that. Huh? Well, let's see if I can still do it. Huh? All right, everybody, just laugh. Gasp, everyone! Oh, something horrible has happened on stage. Oh, a ghost has appeared. Oh, horrible! Oh, gasp, everyone! Oh well, all right. I heard a couple of you anyway. You know, I still got it in me. I can still deliver the goods, but. You know, I'm not so sure that I manipulated the audience so much as they manipulated me. What do you mean, you might say? Well, how do I know that the audience didn't just want to laugh right then, and so they decided to? Huh? And then they manipulated me into doing something that would make them laugh, huh? Because they wanted to, you see? Huh? Well, let me give you an example. Now, every actor has had those moments when the audience just suddenly starts to laugh. Something that the actor didn't even think was funny. It wasn't even supposed to be funny, but it was to them. So what's that all about, eh? I mean, you know, when that happens, it's just like you're in two different plays. It's like you know, the audience is in one play and the actor is in another. It's really a strange situation. I mean, it's sort of like an out-of-body experience. It's like the suddenly way up here, looking down, and you're not even a part of what's going on stage anymore. No, and for just that split second, it's like you're both in a dream and observing it at the same time. Oh, yeah, that's very weird. It's very, very disconcerting. Very strange. Of course, there's lots of strange things in the theater. I mean, let's take the opposite phenomena, the opposite experience. Huh? So now you have a line that you know for certain is funny, right? I mean, you've done it a million times, and every time you did it, it's gotten a laugh. In rehearsal and preview and performance, and then here you are. Huh? You deliver that line again, just like you have a million times before, and thud. Not even a snicker. So what's up with that, huh? I'll be damned if I know. But there you are. It's just like you're there and I'm here. And it's just, it's disconcerting. It's weird. But you know, I feel differently tonight. I feel like there's a certain rapport going on here. I don't know what it is, but I can feel it. You know, last night when you were here and I was here, it was different. It was like we were just kind of getting to know each other, feeling each other out. But tonight there's more chemistry, more electricity. Oh, yes. I don't know. Where do we go from here? I don't know. Oh, yes. Oh, you know, in the theater, we strive for what is genuine. What is the truth? Ah, truth. I should have never gotten started on that one, yeah? Because I love truth, you know? I strive for it, yes. In my art and in my life. Well, maybe not so much in my life, but certainly on stage. Truth, beauty, lights, action. Aha, truth, yes. Oh, you know, there's not nearly enough of it these days. You know, and what passes for truth pales in comparison to what it used to be. Now, you know, in my day, I'll tell you, in my day, I begin to sound a little too pompous, aren't I? That's what one young actress called me.
Too pompous.
Oh, I was hurt for a week.
Well,
maybe she meant it as a compliment. Huh? But I didn't come out here to talk to you about all this stuff. No, I wanted to tell you about my past and how I got to this great stage here, to these boards, to this proscenium. You know? See, I came to the theater, maybe 40 years ago, I guess it was. The damn thing stopped. What time is it anyway? Does anyone know? No? Oh, well, it matters very little. time doesn't matter here in the theater. No, it's just another one of those useless work-a-day world concepts that has no place in here. I mean, because when you're on stage, I mean, you have your own sense, your own concept of the passing of the minutes and hours, huh? Yeah, I mean, you know, whole days to pass in the theater, you know? Whole years, huh? Yeah, 16 years passed between Act 3 and Act 4 of A Winter's Tale, 16 whole years, huh? in the theater, I mean, time can go backwards. You know? You can have flashbacks. Time, within time, within time. And then there's your own time, too, which you can keep track of with your watch when it's working. Now, that. Oh, and it just goes on and on. Yeah. Time. I don't know. Really, really needed in here. Yes. Oh, I don't know. Where are we talking about some time? And then, see, you know, I get lost in the inside, in the dark. I don't know. Time. Yeah, time and truth. Beauty. Now there's the subject. I've known some actresses in my day. I mean, the picture of beauty. Beauty and art. Yes, and since a theater is an art form, beauty and theater. But is theater really beautiful? I mean, in the usual sense of, you know, like a painting or a sculpture or even a dance. I don't know. Of course, the costumes are beautiful, and the sets and the makeup, and the lighting. But it's theater, beautiful, huh? Beyond the trappings of theater, as I like to call it. I don't know. I'd like to think so. I'd like to think that theater is an aesthetic act. You know, I probably shouldn't do this. I mean, I was pressing my luck with the first one. If I was ever to be caught, why not, huh?
Mr. Horn, you know you're not supposed to smoke.
I know. I was just lighting it for my friend.
Your friend?
Yeah, yes, please, yeah.
Where? What friend?
Well, for
Mr. Holmes, I am disappointed in you. You know you're not supposed to smoke, and yet you do it anyway. Can you tell me why? All right, then. Well, I'm afraid I'm going to have to revoke some of your privileges. No gym for you today. You're going to have to stay right here.
I hate Jim. I'd much sooner be here talking with all of you. I mean, you understand. I mean, she does. Well, it's not really her fault. It's society. I mean, what can any of us do? Nothing. We can do nothing. Nothing. We can do nothing. Nothing. Nothing's to be done.
I have a poor, honest creature. Oh, don't hurt me, Mom.
Oh, I'm blathering now, huh? But you're still here, my loyal audience. I wish I could take you home with me. Oh, but I forgot, huh? Oh, this is my home. Well, you are at home with me right now. Well, in that case, welcome. But it's cold in here. Yeah, that's the only thing. You would think that they could at least give you a sweater. Aren't you cold? Huh? Customer! Customer! Would it be too much to ask for a slightly heavier costume here? A vest, maybe? It's freezing out here. Oh, well. I still have my light. Yes. Yes, my hot spot, Oh, that's pleasant. Yeah, very pleasant. Oh, dear. Yes. Well, pleasant, I guess. Pleasant. Here. Yeah, anyway, where? Beauty and truth and truth and beauty, is it art? Art and beauty and art. Yeah, beauty, art and beauty, beauty and art. What did I get for both? Well, my life. I gave them each a part of my life. And where does that leave me? A shallow man. An empty, shallow, washed-up old thespian who's still treading the boards and learning lines and striving for that mystical truth we all strive for. All of my profession, most of whom are gone now, I'm the only one left that I know of. Yeah, they've orphaned me on this stage forever. I suppose I could do worse, but except that I always feel like I'm under a microscope. Yeah, I never feel alone, I mean, you are always here. You can always see me. That's comforting in a way, and frightful. And that's that's the other thing about being an actor. I mean, your every move, every hand gesture, every blink of an eye being scrutinized, observed. I mean, the minute you cross the threshold between backstage and real life out here, it's like you go from one world to another, from the world of the invisible to world of the scene where every wart is exposed, and you feel naked and vulnerable. Yes, no, there's no subterfuge here, no shuffling. Well, I'm quoting again. That's the other thing they say about me, always quoting. It's become a habit. I can't help it, really. It's in my blood. Oh, yes, in my blood. Art. Oh, yes. What is the nature of art? Of the art of nature, I suppose. What's natural and what's artificial? And why is this important? It's a question to be asked, and several questions, really. I have always strived for art's sake. And in my craft, in every play I've taken on, and every part that I've rehearsed and performed here on the stage, I have always tried to create the best art that I could think of. Just like Da Vinci and his palette, or Michelangelo and his chisel and marble. Oh, we're no different. Well, now the the actor and the painter, the actor and the sculptor. Well, except in one way. They're dead and I'm still alive. Well, I mean, they are dead, but their art still is. Their creations are still out there. But for me to still live, I must come out here every night and continue to act, to make real before you what is lying there, dull and lifeless, without my interpretation. Yes. Yes, this script is like the marble, if you will, the blank canvas. Yeah? I must make of this nothing something for your enjoyment, for your pleasure. Everything I do is for you. How profound. How insightful. How strange, huh? It's a strange profession.
Really?
Isn't it? It's very strange, you know? It's here, it's gone. Here, gone. I do it, you come, and then you go, and you come again, and then I come again, and then we come again, and we do it all over, and without you, I am nothing. Yeah. And without me, you are, what are you? Are you nothing too? I'd like to think so. I'd like to think that I am as important to you as you are to me, but am I? Am I? I don't really know. I mean, but it's a sad thought, really. I think that, you are more important to me than I am to you. I mean, it'd be sort of like a love kind of a thing going wrong here, wouldn't it? Unrequited it would be, yes. I'd like to think that we are important to each other. Yes. It's a sad thought. Yes, it's a sad thought that I need you more than you need me. Yeah. How sad? How true, and sadness. Oh yes, they go together in this business, don't they? Yes. Oh yes, how sad. How true. I could use a cigarette. That's what I could use.
Tonight, fried clams.
I hate clams.
And there's lemon and tartar sauce and spinach and onion rings. Enjoy.
Actually, I hate all seafood. It doesn't agree with me. I get nauseous.
And if you need anything else, you just ring that bell, okay? Mm. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is this? Mr. Horn, I am very disappointed in you. Have you been hiding this? You know the regulations.
I didn't smoke it.
Honestly.
I didn't smoke it. I didn't smoke it. Get out of here. I don't need you to do that. Get out! Get out! Get you imbecile! Ignoramus! I still got it in me, huh? To be a force. To be threatening. Oh, bully! Oh, I better sit down. Oh, that took the wind out of my sails. Ah, I'm not as young as I used to be. It's still horse piss. But I scared him. He's gone. I'll pay for it. But what a moment. What a scene.
Mr. Horn, I cannot have you threatening the staff like that. They are here to help you, to serve you. Why would you do something like that? Threaten him with your cane.
He was treating me like a baby.
Yes, I'm sure you had no cause, no reason, no excuse, as always. You don't want us to put you in your room now, do you? You know, you asked to come out here, to have this whole room to yourself, to be fed out here, and then you abuse this privilege by attacking the staff. I must say, Mr. Horn, I don't understand you. You know, you could just as easily be fed in the dining room with everybody else, or confined to your room like the harder cases. This is a privilege coming out here. And such a privilege can just as easily be revoked. Do you understand, Mr. Horn? Do you?
I didn't get him.
Do you? Well, good. All right. Eat your supper. It's good for you. Nice fried clams, spinach, tartar sauce, lemon.
I don't like spinach.
Onion rings.
They don't agree with me.
What a treat.
I hate it.
It's not every day we get this kind of treat. Whoopsie, now is it?
Yucky. Pooey, I won't eat it.
There. Now, you don't need me to feed you, do you? Good. All right. Well, ring if you need us. Oh, I almost forgot. Open. Come on. Come on.
Spinach, onions. Is there nothing else? Is there nothing else to this existence? You know. You know who I really am. I'm here. For you, every night, night after night, without fail, the show must go on. Yes. Oh, yes. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yes. Thank you for coming. Oh, no. It was nothing, really. I'm afraid I only put on half a performance tonight. I'm feeling a bit out of sorts, you see. Come see me next week. Then you'll see a real performance, huh? A tour de force. Well, I suppose I must eat something. Mm.
No, no.
Goodness, I lost most of my taste buds years ago. I'd hate to have to taste that lump. Oh, where was I? What is it? Back to the theater? The theater, yes. Oh, the theater, an illusion, yeah. Oh, there's the rub, yeah. Illusion, huh? I could talk all night about that. Take this situation here. You and I here in this theater. Is it real? Well, of course it's real. I mean, you're here, I'm here. We're here in this place, at this time. Unmistakably. It's completely real, isn't it? Yes, it is. Yeah. Well, all right, then that settles it, huh? Well, not completely, because now a play is not real. It's a representation of what? Well, of reality. So a play is not reality, but what it represents is, right? Yeah, well, I suppose so. But what about that reality? Their reality, that witch's reality, is that real? See, they don't see you. No, they don't. They don't think you're real. It's true. Yeah. So where does that leave you? Well, where does that leave us? Do we have our own separate reality, our own parallel universe? Well. Possibly, I guess. I mean, it's hard to say. Really, it's kind of like the old tree in the forest sort of thing. If I'm not here to see you and feel you, do you exist? To them, no. You do not exist. So maybe that's where I come in. Maybe that's where you need me, because I can see you and they can't. Yeah, yeah. And without me, you wouldn't exist. that makes me feel better. it's nice to be needed. Yeah. No, it's been a long time since I've been needed by someone. Yeah. I mean, really needed. You see, I've been out of practice. I've been off the boards for a while. Oh, just doing this, doing that. Mostly that. Just nonsense things you have to do to survive. But I couldn't get all the good roles. Well, they started going to younger people, younger blood. But then my chance came. This script. And voila! Here I am, at your disposal, backed by popular demand. Yes. So this is my return to the theater, if you will. Hopefully it's not my swan song. I mean, I'd like to think that there are other roles out there for me, that I'll have other offers. Maybe someone will see me in this show tonight and. Maybe I'll get a good review or something, and maybe another producer or another director, or maybe even one of you out there will see me and want me in another production. I mean, I've got a variety of experience. I mean, I've done tragedy, I've done comedy, and everything in between. I have an extensive resume. Oh, yes. Many roles, many theaters, many triumphs, and I mean, I hope they're seen that way. I hope there's been charity out there and people will remember me. Yeah, I mean, because that's really the only way that I exist. And, you know, that's the only way. I mean, yeah, that's, I mean, you can't go to a museum and see my work or to a library. I mean, you can't walk down the street and see me. No, you know, it's be right here, right now, in this place, here in this hall. Yeah. Don't let them take that away from you. No. No. Don't ever let them take that. Remember me. Remember me. I'm getting tired now. Old and tired. I'm worn down by life, by love, by everyday bloodied existence, day after day. But here with you, my audience, my people, here I am alive, I exist, I have meaning. There's that music, lovely, sweet music, I love it. Fall onto the rafters? Did you put them here, all of you? Oh, they're lovely, yes. What a stunning bouquet they make. Oh, they're heavenly, yes. Oh, they make me want to sing, to dance. Oh, yes.
Mr. Horn, it's bedtime. Where on earth did you get those flowers? Did somebody pick them for you? Probably Mrs. Bonham. She's always disappearing into the courtyard and picking things. Here, let me see them. I'll put them in some water. Chocolate mousse, I believe.
I hate chocolate.
And mint ice cream.
I hate mint.
Yummy, yummy.
And ice.
Very tasty, I've been told.
And cream.
Very, very tasty. Look, you really must eat something, right? Shall I feed you? Would you Perhaps I shall. We haven't done it in a while, have we? We could try that. Okay? Let me see. All right, what do we have here? Okay. All right now. Open wide. Here comes a little airplane into the hangar. Oh! Look what you've done! You naughty, naughty boy! Pick that up. All right, that is it. That is enough. Go get them. Go. You leave me no choice. Mr. Horn, you repeatedly disobeyed the rules. Cigarettes, attacking the orderlies, and now this. Is this what you want? Is this how you want to be from now on? Is this how you want to be remembered? You think I enjoy it?
Come on.
Back to your room. Come on, let's go. Back to your room.
Today. I'm feeling chipper. Maybe it's because they gave me this book, the History of Theater. I'm very interested in history, and especially theatrical history and how it's changed over the years. You know, the Greeks performed on a bare stage, sort of like this one, only not even a chair or a table. Nothing. Just emptiness, and all theater begins that way, with an idea, a little seed, a germ. It grows and gets fleshed out, it blossoms, puts out shoots, little arguments to the heavens, if you will. The Greeks did that, Sophocles, Euripides, Aeschylus, Aristophanes, and the Romans did that too, Seneca, Plautus, and all the rest. And then all of them started with just a seed, an idea. And before that, there was nothing, an emptiness, a vast wasteland of potentiality. And so it is with me, with us. So to speak, we begin with nothing, quite literally, a hole, or a space into which we pour this passion, this intensity, these feelings and emotions, thoughts, and dreams. We create out of nothing, drama, and this book here. Chronicles all of that, all of these dramas that just appeared out of someone's brain. And here they are, all neatly arranged for us in chronological order, the Greeks, the Romans, the Renaissance, the Elizabethans, right up to modern times, right up to our times. I mean, this is one of them. I mean, this began with nothing, and just blank pages, and now it's thoughts and ideas and proposals, arguments. I've done some deep plays here. I was Creon. Antigone by Sophocles. I was in The Birds once. Oh, strange play, The Birds. Marvelous play. Oh, and of course I've done Shakespeare, Marlowe, Johnson, on and on. But what's it all mean? What's it all come down to? That's what I'd like to know. I mean, they must have had something in mind to have written all that, you know? Just to make money, or to survive. Well, possibly, but I'd be willing to speculate that in every instance in this poem here, it became something else, and something more meaningful, something more profound. They knew they were on something, something important. They wanted to reach out. They wanted to connect with their fellow man, I think, yes, to reach out to them, to communicate, and in some instances, in the best instances, they wanted to change them, to affect them, to move them. Just as I, a poor player, hoping to do so now. Yeah. It's that reaching out into the darkness and then the feebly grasping for something, anything, another hand or another mind, another body. That's what it's all about, I think. Yeah, I think so. I know so. I mean, why else would they have done it? Why else do we still do it? This shadow boxing here, this lighting of the darkness, this illumination. And then why do you do it? I mean, why do you come out of your houses in the night to watch me here? I mean, what is it about it? Huh? I mean, what's enjoyable? What's interesting? What's worthwhile? I mean, I'd like to know. I mean, because despite years and years of acting, I still don't know why I do it. Why I come out here like this? I mean, is it just vanity or a pride or a fear, insanity, idiocy, all of the above? I don't know. It's all a mystery to me. Yeah. I'd like to know. I want to know. I'm afraid you won't tell me. Huh? Will you? No. I'll have to figure it out for myself. Yeah. So this is my tragedy, so to speak. Well, our tragedy. All of us. I mean, we can't really know why we're here. Why we keep endlessly revisiting these places we've been before for generations, for eons. It's something, I tell you. It'll be there. Here's a play I've never done. Yeah. A School for Scandal by Sheridan. Let's see, here's another one. Months in the Country. Huh? Yes, I'd seen that once. Very good, as I recall. And all arguments, ideas, seeds, germs. What was I talking about? I've forgotten. Something profound, no doubt. Ah, there's that music again. Oh, how lovely, how sweet it is.
Mr. Horn. And how are we today?
Oh.
Are we feeling better?
No.
Did we get a good night's sleep?
No.
You seem a bit tired. Would you like some tea? Chocolate biscuit, perhaps? Well, in case you've forgotten, tonight is bingo night. Starts in 10 minutes in the common room. You know, you haven't been in a while. The others are beginning to ask for you. Mrs. Bonham, Mrs. Carter, Mr. Garrick, Mr. Keene. They miss you. You sure you don't want to go? All right, well, suit yourself. Don't say I didn't try.
Bingo. What bosh.
N41. G59. O65. Bingo!
Who cares? See, they don't know you're here. Yeah, that I'm not actually alone. They think I'm all alone here, but I've got you. The joke's on them. I've got you, and you've got me. And if I were to leave here right now and go play bingo with the rest of them, where would you be? Well, you'd be gone, wouldn't you? Yeah, you'd just get up and leave because there'd be nothing going on here. No. I mean, then I'd lose you, and I wouldn't like that, no, because then I'd have nothing to live for, no.
B-15. O-62. G-48. O-71. I-19.
Bingo! Okay.
Don't leave me, will you? Don't ever leave me. And I won't leave you. No, never. That's why I must stay here. Always. So you won't leave me. Where was I? Theater. History. History of theater. Let's see. Yeah, we'll go to theater. It's on page. It must be on page. Yeah, one more. I think it's history of theater. Where was I? Yes, history, the history of theater, and the theater of history, I suppose. You know, isn't history itself rather theatrical? I mean, they talk about the theater of war, they say, stages of development, acts, scenes, intermissions, here and there. Yes, and history sort of lends itself to theatrical interpretation, doesn't it? That's why there's plays are written about real life, and history of the world, world events, and our own little private histories as well. I mean, life is a drama, like a play. Scenes, divisions, crises, catastrophes, climaxes, endings, and resolutions. And of course, every life has a beginning, and a middle, and an end. And well, what more can he say about it? great deal, apparently. This volume here is a great deal about all of that. Oh, yes. And now I'm suddenly sad. Why? Well, because there are just scores and scores of plays in here that I've never been in. I've never even read. And I call myself an actor. Well, these are apparently some of the most important dramas ever written, and I haven't even read some of them. Oh, what a disaster. What a calamity. Well, I shall hurry up and read them now. While I still have time, yes. But then I wouldn't be able to be here talking with you, would I? No, because, I don't want to lose you. I want to keep your attention. You might just leave me here. I wouldn't like that at all. No. I guess I'll just have to settle for this one. What is it? The Idiot's Tale. What a strange title. That's a strange play, don't you think? Oh, but then you've probably never read it, have you? I don't think it's well known. Why should it be? I mean, it's just some hack writer. Nobody. But it appealed to me. I read it and then I wanted to perform it because it called out to me. It said, "Horn, get up there and act me now." So here I am, a creation of this play, and I'm reading this play and I'm acting it too. And I shall do it again and again and again. Because I must. I mean, this was written for me to perform night after night, and so I must perform it. I must interpret it, or else it dies. It becomes rubbish, trash. It gets thrown out. A play is meant to be performed, not to gather dust or to grow moldy. It should be a living, breathing piece of work. I'm trying to do it justice in my own pathetic way. Why did you like it? You might ask. I don't know. Because it seemed to be about me and about my life in the theater, and it raised questions and issues that I've grappled with myself, if only unconsciously, without thinking too much about it. It seemed to me like it has, some potential, some real possibilities, some ideas, some options, I guess, as I say. I'm just blathering here. I don't know where I'm going. I don't have any idea. I just have to be honest with you. It's not so easy remembering these lines anymore. It doesn't come naturally like they used to. We must be back in there somewhere. Let's see. We're on page 23. We're already at page 23. We're making good time then. Yes, yes. Well, let me see here. Okay, all right. Let's see. But it seemed real relevant, alive with possibilities. Oh, I think that's what I was supposed to say. Yeah. I don't know what the hell it was all about, but I guess I was supposed to say it. Yeah, it called out to me and said, Horn, get up here and act me now. Now, that makes no sense. Yeah, come on, yeah. That's too far back. You know, that's where the witch came in, I think. Theater. The history of theater and the theater of history, I suppose. The hell do you suppose that was what? I don't get it. That's pretty lame. Is this even the right script? It doesn't sound right. I guess it is. You know, there are just pages and pages of just rubbish here. It's just, a pure drivel, just nonsense. What poppycock, isn't it? You know, I might just as well have been talking gibberish. Well, that gives me an idea. Why don't I just try that and see if it makes any difference here? Yeah. Glooks, block, and bloogles, bleed. Rumbly, bottom, doden, ballet, poop, chewy. Boat, chock, and doodly, bot, toop, and doobly. Yeah, boom, bada, roo, buff, lala, lada, bring back the wool. Heat that a doo, blue, the bala, bow, but hit a bun, bing, bing, bow, the doo, play. Hit the boom, pop, tada, woo, but they may beat your home, well, they may be, but if I hope they can take a mother. Black, took a doodle, baby. Oh, my God, three of us, way of us, day of us, oh, and Lutsky, oh, very gully, boom. Heat that the hoo, wada, 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 wada.
What's this all about, Mr. Horn? If you want to make a fool of yourself, you can do it in your own room, on your own time, not out here in the public space. Maybe it's time. All right, none of that. Mr. Horn, people are beginning to wonder what's going on. All right? Look, see, you've already caused a sensation. Look what you've done. You've interrupted the bingo game. Go back to the game.
Sorry about that last time. I just lost it. I truly lost it. I don't really know what happened, if I can fully explain it. Well, I was frustrated, I guess. I mean, the script just didn't make any sense. There was no dialogue. It was just nonsense. And I couldn't handle that nonsense, and so I just lost it. I mean, that's all. You know, I mean, as an actor, I rely on the playwright to at least make sense. I have a recognizable through line, you know, at least a beginning, a middle, and an end, not just gobbledygook like that. I mean, you know, a play should make sense, don't you think? I mean, there should be recognizable situations, you know, people doing things, making rational decisions, Well, or at least the subtext should be clear. I mean, what people are thinking, what's going on in the character's minds. I mean, am I right, or is this crazy? I mean, is this an outdated concept that a play should be transparent in some way? No, that's not quite the right word. What is it that I'm trying to say, huh? I mean, we here, you come to the theater to see a story, right? I mean, you want to see people doing things, not just gibberish, not that. I mean, in the old days, I mean, in my time, there were stories. There were people doing things, relating to one another. I mean, there was love and hate and machination. There was irony and plot development. I mean, there were things that literally kept you on the edge of your seat. But oh boy, not anymore. No. I mean, today when you go to the theater, you might see anything. I mean, quite literally, anything. You know, people are taking off their clothes now routinely. You know, people are doing the performance art, whatever the hell that means. I mean, there was just no verisimilitude anymore. No, not even any attempt at it. I'm telling you. You know, the theater is just dead. Or at least dying. No, but not here, huh? No, here it's still alive. You and I, yes, we are the keepers of the flame, aren't we? Yes, yes, we here, single-handedly, we are keeping the spirit of Shakespeare alive. Yes, yes, and Ibsen and Moliere and all the rest. You do believe in me, don't you? You do agree with me. What's important? What's real? What is real? What is real anymore? I'd like to know. I used to know. Oh, I did. I used to. I at least I thought I knew. But now it seems beclouded. Yeah? Beclouded. Is that even a word? Beclouded? Well, it is now. I just said it. So it must be real. It's all so fleeting, isn't it? Yeah. Yes. Oh, the theater, I mean. How do I mean life? Well, both, really. You and I here, you there, me here, us here in this cavern, this empty space, this cave. Oh, well, I'm blathering again, aren't I? But I hate to admit it, to me who has always been so. Oh, so erudite, I guess, so real, always striving for the truth, the elusive truth. I don't even know what's making sense anymore, and what's not. I suppose it's in the nature of this game, this medium here, this genre, and that's. That's why there's never any dialogue about this sort of thing. No, I mean, I come here, I do my thing, and you sit there rapt, or maybe not, maybe bored. Maybe just sit there out of a sense of obligation, because if you did decide to leave in the middle of a performance, well, you'd create quite a ruckus in this quiet little theater here. Okay? Yeah, I want to say that it's not as good if you were just sitting at home watching the TV where you could just switch off, or even in a movie theater where if you did get up and leave, I mean, you wouldn't offend the actors because they're not even there, not in front of you in real life, like here in the theater. So you sit there quietly, impatiently, and wait for the appropriate moment when the show is over, done, finished. And what I mean to say is, I mean, you come here, I do my thing, and then it's over. You clap, perhaps politely, perhaps not, and then you leave. It's over. And so I never get to know what you're really thinking about, what you really think of my performance. No, I mean, well, I might get the odd review, perhaps, if I'm lucky, if they even bother to show up. But even then, that's only one person's opinion, and I don't care about them. I care about you and what you think. You know, but that's the tragedy of the stage. That's the real tragedy. One never knows. I mean, because the only way you can really know is just right in the performance itself. I mean, in the listening and in the observing and in the, you know, projecting it's just all right there in the moment because everything else is just it's untrustworthy. It's beclouded. You know, there's that word again. Beclouded by time and by distance, by any number of distracting thoughts. And so if I run into you on the street or in a restaurant or maybe at a party and you say, oh, yes, you did such a fine job the other night and such, well, how do I know that your judgment, your opinion isn't beclouded by something else, by maybe a remark you overheard or a review you read or something at work, or alcohol, or anything. No, you know, the real tragedy of the theater is not what's going on with the character on stage, but with the actor himself, with the illusoriness of the illusion, and the never being able to achieve what is being strived for. What has been strived for ever since primitive man attempted for the first time in front of a flickering flame in a dark cave some thousands and thousands of years ago, a representation of something through the process of performance. And what is that? What is being strived for? The truth? I believe so. I believe it is. And the final tragedy is never being able to achieve the truth through an essentially untruthful medium. How profound. How epistemal. How true. How tragic.
Mr. Horn, it's time. It's time. We must be going now.
Going? Where?
Don't you remember? We have been over and over this. Look, you're being transferred to a more secure facility where they can handle you. Where they'll take better care of you. All right? Look, I'm sure you'll like it there. I mean, they have a little room for you. nice bed. They have a very well-trained staff who will be able to keep a much better eye on you. Well, you'll be more confined, okay? So you won't get so out of control. So you won't get so confused, okay? And be moved around all the time, which is very confusing for the staff. And for you, too, I'm sure. It will be calmer there, more peaceful, hopefully. You'll be happier there, I hope. Look, they know how to deal with you there, okay? They understand people like you. They are trained professionals. Do you see? Do you understand what I'm talking about? Are you ready? Are you ready now, Mr. Horn?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow? And tomorrow, will anything be different, Mr. Horn? No, not tomorrow. Not tomorrow. Today, now, this moment, okay? You have all your things packed. It's time to go now.
What about them?
All right, Mr. Horn. Look, I hate to have to tell you this, but there is nobody out there, okay? I mean, it's just a blank wall on all sides. There is no audience. It's all in your mind. Don't you see? It's all in your imagination. You made them up. You're not on stage anymore, Mr. Horn. You're in a nursing facility, and you're being transferred to a more secure facility for your own good. Do you understand what I'm talking about? Do you?
Goodbye. I'm sorry. I didn't think this would end. I thought we had more time together. I didn't realize this was the last act, the last scene. I won't be back anymore. This is really it. Can I take a bow?
All right, but be quick about it. They're waiting.
Oh, this is it. The final curtain. The final bow. There'll be no encore this time. And no going round to the dressing room afterwards, either, I'm afraid. I must make a hasty exit. I can't tell you how much I've enjoyed this, you and I. This has been the opportunity of a lifetime, the performance of a lifetime here with you is one last time. I want it to last forever, but nothing does. Nothing ever does. Oh. I have just one last word of advice for all you young people out there who might be thinking about acting, considering a career on the stage. And it's an honorable profession, a fulfilling profession. It's a good use of your time. Don't give up. Don't get discouraged. Just keep plugging away and striving for what was I going to say? It's getting dizzy. You're going around like a whirligig. I'm getting dizzy. Maybe I better just sit down.
Oh my God, Mr. Horn! Mr. Horn!
Help me! Help! I'm dying, Egypt!
What does that even mean?
Who knows? Just keep him vertical.
Remember, always remember. What was I going to say?
Go get the.
Where am I?
Mr. Horn! Calm down! It's all right. We're going to take good care of you. Just settle down. It's okay. All right, Mr. Horn.
All right. What?
What are you doing here?
What is it?
How can I bow in this contraption? Leave me alone! Stop it!
What's it, use? All right. Goodbye! 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 Goodbye!
I just wanted to let you know that Mr. Horn has been transferred to a more intensive care facility. In a real hospital. He was just starting to go out of control to lose it. Now, I'm sorry. I mean, I know that you liked coming here. Being here with him. And that he enjoyed it, too. Just that... we really didn't have any choice. He was just becoming too unpredictable, too out of control, and, sometimes, downright crazy. Of course, I mean, he is crazy. Well, I hope you knew that. I mean, you did know that, didn't you, that this is a facility for people like him? Well... Of course he did. Who am I talking to? A bunch of children? No, I'm sorry. I get so used to talking to the inmates. Patients. Who? Well, sometimes have a few screws loose. Like Mr. Horn. Now, he's a nice man and all. Or, well, at least so I've been told. And he has family that comes to visit him here. Son, a daughter. They talk glowingly of him in his past life. Well, before he came here. Of how the stage meant so much to him. He was an actor when he was younger.
But I mean, I'm sure you knew that. I mean, even if you knew nothing else about him, I'm sure you knew that.
What's this? Looks like a play that he was writing. The Idiot's Tale by Lester Horne. Yep, that's him. Huh. Didn't know he was a playwright. You know, I should probably hold on to this. His family might want to see it. You know, wonder if he finished it. Yep, the end it says. Must be finished. I wonder what it's about. Can't really say. It's one big monologue, mostly. Oh, with a few little scenes with others. The Idiot's Tale. Doesn't sound much like the title of a play. Sounds more like a book. A novel, maybe. Isn't there a book called The Idiot out there? Yeah. Written by, by some Russian guy, I think. Well, maybe there's a connection. Maybe it's a retelling of The Idiot. Well, can't really say.
There you are. What are you doing in here?
Nothing. Cleaning up.
I thought I heard voices. I heard you talking.
Talking? Well, Mr. Horn used to come here and talk to the walls and pretend they were his audience?
Yeah.
I just thought it was kind of sad him not being here anymore, so I thought I'd talk to his audience. Kind of say goodbye.
You're not crazy too, are you?
What? No, nothing like that. Just a little bit of fantasy, that's all.
You a frustrated actor or something?
Who, me? No, I mean, I've never really given it much thought. What about you?
Me?
Yeah, you ever fancied yourself an actress?
Me? Oh, God, no way. I'd be scared shitless to get up on stage.
Why? I mean, you sort of perform every day, don't you?
What do you mean?
Well, for your job, you have to perform for the residents, the patients.
That's different.
Huh. Is it?
Yeah, I mean, I don't have to learn lines or anything.
Well, but maybe that just makes it harder then.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, there's no script to go by, so you just kind of have to make it up as you go along.
I suppose, but isn't that kind of like life? I mean, you run into somebody, you gotta make up something to say.
Sure, but I mean, that doesn't make it any less of a performance, does it?
You're weird.
Whatever.
What's this? The Idiot's Tale. Huh, what is this?
Oh, it's a play that he was writing. Mr. Horn.
Oh, I didn't know it was a play, right?
Yeah, me neither. What should we do with it?
I don't know. But, it's an idiot's tale, then I don't suppose it really means very much, does it? So, I guess it doesn't really matter.
Really?
What?
You're just gonna throw it out, just like that?
Well, he left it here, didn't he? He abandoned it. He obviously didn't want it.
Yeah, but aren't you at least a little bit curious about what he wrote?
Are you kidding? Tale told by an idiot? Come on, I got work to do.